if you're setting ignition timing using the factory mark, there's a good chance it's wrong. In this video, I show you how to find the true top dead center, not the gassed one. Stay with me. Most flywheels there are marking that indicate TDC, but these markings are usually not very accurate. To find the exact top dead center, the best method is using a piston stop tool and a degree wheel. The reason for using these tools is that the flywheel mark can be inaccurate to the machining errors. With this method you can verify it, or sometimes may the flywheels has no mark at all, or the engine setup is complicated, so using these tools have become necessary. Actually, True TDC is not the flywheel mark and not what you see by eye. True TDC point is only where the tools tell us. Here you can see a piston stop tool and degree wheels that I made it myself. You can buy them from shops or you can build it yourself. It's not matter. What matter is it must made of a strong metal and completely flat. See? This screw for adjustment. When the piston it does not stop, you can lower the screw and adjust it. And for degree wheel, you can find the free template in internet and print it as a sticker. Then stick it on a DVD like that. You just need to be very precise when doing this. Let me explain step by step what need to be done. Stay with me. Step 1. Installing the degree wheel. First, bring the piston up. You can use a flywheel mark. If you have a dial indicator, you can use it too. If the cylinder head is removed, you can bring the piston to the highest point by the eye. Look. Move it back and forth a bit. That's it. Now, install the degree wheel on the crankshaft. The degree wheel need to mount it on the crankshaft. You can install it on the flywheel side or other side. It doesn't matter really, but make sure it's centered and not loosened. You can use a bushing or some adapter like that and washers. For now, don't move the crankshaft. Tighten it a little bit. That's it. Let's go on the next step. Step 2. Install the pointer. For the pointer, you can use a simple flexible wire like that. Fix it onto the engine body wherever is easier for you. Tighten it. That's it. Perfect. Without touch. After that, bring it close to the zero of the degree wheel. Turn the degree wheel. That's it. You can tighten the bolt now. Now when you turn the crankshaft, the degree wheel should turn with it. Like that. Step 3. Installing the piston stop. Install the piston stop in right position. If your cylinder head is on, you can use the piston stop tool that screws in a spark plug hole. Now move the piston back a little so you can install properly. Like that. Use a spacer and a couple of washers and secure that with nuts. Step 4, finding the angle before and after TDC. In this step, slowly turn the crankshaft with a hand or wrench, whichever size is easier for you, until the piston hits the stop. Look. That's it. Now we must write down the number the pointer shoe on the degree wheel. Mine is 15 degree after TDC. Now turn the crankshaft in the opposite direction until the piston stop again. Like, be careful, don't move the pointer or degree wheel, just crankshaft. Read the number again and write it down. And mine is 20 degrees before top dead center. For mine, the difference between the two sides is 5 degrees before and after TDC. Remember, the degree difference may vary between different engines, but the difference between side after top center and before top center, if it's large, you definitely made a mistake somewhere. I explain important tips in description. You can check it out. Step 5. Find the real top dead center. Now we must add two of these numbers together. 15 plus 20. It's 13.5. Now we divided this result by 2. 13.5 divided by 2. 17.5. This is the real TDC. This is where the most people get it wrong. Now, without moving the crankshaft, loosen the degree wheel a little bit. It's enough. And set it to the final number we get, -70.5. Just turn the degree wheel, not crankshaft. It's 15, 16, 17, 70.5. That's it. Now you can tighten the degree wheel really carefully. For final check, and now if the piston stop either side, before and after top dead center, the number should be 17.5, like that. Look, it is 17.5. Turn the crankshaft opposite. We got a 70.5 here. If the number is the same in both direction, it means you did it right, everything. Now we have a TDC point, and we can remove the piston stop tool. Set it on the zero and check the top. As you can see, the 0 point on the pointer shows the highest point of the piston in cylinder. Now that we found the real top dead center, we can move on the other topics like a ignition advance. Without real top dead center, advance timing doesn't make sense. And also, now we can verify the mark on the flywheel or check the valve opening and closing angles, camshaft, and other things. Thanks for watching. In the next parts, I talk more about this and ignition timing. If you like this video, please like it and leave your thoughts for me. Farewell.